Bishop Ryan recognizes and acknowledges that the Hamilton-Wentworth Catholic District School Board is situated upon the traditional territories of the Erie, Neutral, Huron-Wendat, Haudenosaunee, and Mississaugas. This is covered by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, which was an agreement between the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe to share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. We further acknowledge that this land is covered by the Between the Lakes Purchase, 1792, between the Crown and the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation. Please stop and stand for the singing of our national anthem.
Prepare for the upcoming Thanksgiving weekend. Let us pray in thanksgiving. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God of gifts, thank you for the blessings you have given us. May we always use your gifts and talents in a way that demonstrate kindness, humility, and compassion. May we continue to do our part in developing our gifts, keep our hearts and minds open to the direction of the Spirit, who calls us to celebrate our gifts by sharing them with others. Amen. Bishop Ryan, pray for us in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good morning, staff and students. This is a very important message for all students participating in this fall's administration of the Ontario Secondary School Literacy Test, also known as the OSSLT. Bishop Ryan grade 10, grade 11, and non-graduating grade 12 students will be participating in the OSSLT during the fall session beginning Wednesday, October 13th to Thursday, October 21st. Information was sent home to parents yesterday, and your homeroom classroom teachers may have already shared with you the date that your class is writing. It is very important for you to note that if you are a non-graduating grade 12 student participating in the OSSLT, you will not be writing in your homeroom class. You will be writing in the cafeteria on Thursday, October 21st. Similarly, if you are a co-op student or a grade 10 or 11 student not currently enrolled in a grade 10 or 11 period 1 class, you too will be writing the OSSLT on Thursday, October 21st in the cafeteria. Students learning remotely who wish to participate in the OSSLT have indicated their interest by completing a survey. Arrangements under the guidance of public health will be made for safe in-person participation. If you are a remote learner and you have indicated your interest in completing the assessment, stay tuned for more information on where to report on your scheduled day. Now, how can students prepare for the online OSSLT? Students can prepare for the field test by accessing the OSSLT My Class site. The My Class site provides students with numerous practice assessments similar to what they will encounter on the OSSLT field test. The prep site also includes a video that provides an overview of the online platform and outlines what students will need to know for test day. In addition, EQAO has offered students the opportunity to become familiar with the online test and its platform through EQAO's online practice test. Participating students are encouraged to prepare and practice before their designated test day. That's all for me. Stay tuned for more WRBR.
Good morning, Bishop Ryan. This announcement is for all math students interested in the after-school tutoring program. Miss Dinto will be running it on Tuesday and Thursdays in room 223 West after school at 2:45 to 4:15 p.m. Please get your form for your math teacher or visit, visit Miss Dentino in workroom 8 to pick up your form to register. We'll be starting on Tuesday, October 12th. Thank you. Attention all Art Club members. Don't forget our meeting tomorrow after school in the art room. New members are always welcome. See you there. Hey, BR players. The turnout for this year's school play editions for Hot Rod, Cruising the 50s was amazing. Thank you to all. Today, the callback list will be posted. So if you're on this list, please attend your callback edition tomorrow, Thursday, on your lunch or after school in room 102, the drama room. If your name isn't on the list, don't worry. You might have already gotten the part. We just need some people to return to make a final decision about certain roles. So once again, the callbacks will be posted today. Attend your callbacks tomorrow, and the final cast list will be posted on Friday. Break a leg, BR players. Break a leg. To all members and allies of Celtic Free, our next meeting will take place this Thursday, October 7th, tomorrow to be exact, right after school in room 209. This week's activity will be tie-dye shirts, so grab a blank white t-shirt, bring a friend, and join us in our safe space for some midweek fun. We can't wait to see you there. Attention all students passionate about video. The Celtic Video Crew, or the CVC, are looking for your talent. Join the Celtic video team in the studio or room 114 if you're interested in capturing highlights at games and school events. We need you this year, and you can earn precious service hours. Don't delay, join CVC today. That's all from me, so stay tuned for more great announcements.
Good morning, Bishop Ryan. It's Mr. Mazza here with a special announcement for the Bishop Ryan Writers Circle. We will be meeting today after school in room 229. So that's today after school in room 229. Hope to see all of you there. Have a great day.
Good morning, everyone. Football Friday is coming up, and I want to take the time to thank all the coaches and athletes for doing an amazing job. And now, here is Mr. D. Ben with more wrestling announcements.
Oh, good morning, Bishop Ryan. Well, I'm here on behalf of Coach Francis and the Bishop Ryan coaching staff. Today, we're going to be starting our registration or sign-ups for this year's varsity girls and boys wrestling team. And we want to encourage as many new members as possible, the grade nines. Don't let this opportunity pass you by while you're here at Bishop Ryan in your years of wrestling. Our sport has been around since 1969, and we are the number one school now in the province since the last officer championship has declared us the number one school. And we want to give you guys an opportunity to experience this sport. So the way we're doing it is the registration, you're going to find look for a poster that looks like this with a QR code on the bottom, and just scan the QR code. It'll bring you to the registration form, which you fill out, and you'll submit. And we will be starting our training sessions when we come back from the Thanksgiving weekend on the Tuesday. We are a winter sport, so we know that there's some students that are on a fall team. You are still to register, even though you won't be joining us for training until after your season's over. So we wish as many kids to come out this year for our VR wrestling team. And that's all I have for today. Back to WRBR.
Do hear us go back.
Hey BR, it's Juliana here from BRSC with a HOCO announcement. Homecoming is coming up next week. Stay tuned for some fun activities like door decorating, cahoots, and much more. Stay tuned for more info coming to you this week. Have a great day, and please stand by for the lockdown procedure video.
Hello, staff and students. Today, we'll be reviewing our lockdown procedures. Recently, the staff received a handout which detailed the necessary procedures, roles, and responsibilities of the administration, staff, and students. This was to prepare everyone in case we are ever confronted with an apparent or real threat to the school. I ask that you thoroughly review the Bishop Ryan Lockdown Procedures handout. Today, we will also review the necessary procedures that would take place if you were ever required to secure the school in any of the following scenarios known as hold and secure or shelter in place. So, when would we initiate a lockdown situation? Well, we would proceed with going into lockdown if there were ever a major incident or violent threat to the school. Therefore, a lockdown is used to prevent you from leaving or entering the building and restricting your movement within your classroom or any other area that you may be located during that particular time. If any staff member suspects or detects an intruder that may pose a serious threat in the building, we would immediately initiate the lockdown procedure by doing the following. If possible, take notice of what the individual was wearing, as well as the time and the individual's exact location. We would then call 911 to provide them with the necessary details. An administrator would then announce over the PA system and state the following. The school is in lockdown. I repeat, the school is in lockdown. After the announcement is made, the lockdown tone or siren will sound continuously over the PA during the entire lockdown. Immediately after that, that is when we all move into action and proceed with doing the following. Staff should ask anyone who is in the hallway outside of the classroom to come in and then lock the door. If a staff member is near a washroom, gather the students into the nearest classroom and lock the door. If you are a teacher on hall supervision, you would also insist in moving students out of the hallways and into the nearest unlocked classroom. And if possible, lock the classroom door. Do not bring students into a large gathering, such as a gymnasium, for obvious reasons of visibility and being seen by an intruder. If any staff or students are in the washroom, you can evacuate, but only if it is possible to do so. In this case, go to the nearest class or area that can be locked down. However, if you are not able to do so and you must stay in the washroom, then retreat to the furthest stall from the entrance. Lock the stall door and stand or crouch on top of the toilet, remaining calm and quiet. This would also apply to students who are in the gymnasium change rooms. You also would need to retreat into a washroom stall since you will not be able to lock the door from the inside. Once you are in the classroom or secure area, everyone must move away from the door and windows and assume a prone position, in other words, lying low to the floor. Turn out any lights enclose any blinds. If there is a window on the classroom door, consider covering the window to not allow any potential sight lines. Everyone must turn off their cell phones or place them on vibrate. The cell phones should only be used for an emergency to communicate critical information to the principal. Staff should keep the students calm and quiet. If it is a prolonged lockdown, staff should be aware of any students with significant medical conditions, such as asthma, diabetes, or anaphylaxis. At the same time, any students that do have medical conditions, we ask that you keep your puffer, EpiPen, and/or insulin pumps with you at all times. Remember, do not open the door for anyone until you are released by either the police department or a school administrator. For those staff members who are supervising the cafeteria, you would be evacuating and moving the students outside by making your way through the exit doors located in the southwest corner of the cafeteria, which leads to the portables and the turf field area. If the threat is coming from the front of the building, which is the Rymo Road entrance, and you cannot exit through back doors of the cafeteria, you can leave through the school parking lot doors. Lastly, if the threat were coming from the back parking lot, you would need to exit through the front of the school by going through exit 1A or the north exit, which also leads to Rymo Road. Staff and students who are in the library can move to any one of the following two areas. Depending on how many students are in the library, there is a seminar room located on the east side of the library, which should be the first choice. And if there is no room, you can move to the south side of the library near where the couches and seating area is located. Ensure that the blinds in that location are closed. Once again, a reminder to be lying or in a crouched down position. If you are in gyms A, B, or C, you are to move immediately into the equipment storage room. Each of the gym areas has their own storage room. If you happen to be in gym C, you also have the option of going into the wrestling room and placing yourself in a position where there are no potential sight lines that can be seen from the glass entrance into the wrestling room. For staff and students in portables, you would ensure that you lock the door and tip the desks over in the middle of the room, creating a circle with the desktops facing outwards and assuming a lying down position behind the desks. For those students who may be outside the school and you hear the lockdown tone, then you must move as far away from the building as possible and evacuate to Our Lady of Assumption Catholic School if you are in grade 9 or 10,
or Shannon Kustachin if you are in grades 11 or 12.
You would remain there until further direction by Hamilton Police Services or a school administrator, or by accessing the school board website to receive any updates concerning the lockdown. Any staff or students who have a safety plan in place, I would ask that you please ensure that the plan is reviewed carefully, especially with those staff members who may be a part of the plan and or responsible in caring for those students. If during a lockdown, the fire alarm goes off, and there is no immediate danger from visible smoke or actual fire, you must stay in lockdown. However, if you see smoke or fire and it is threatening your life, then move to a safer location. Lastly, during the lockdown, you must not open the door for anyone, and you must wait to be released by either the police department or a school administrator. At this moment, I would like to go through two other scenarios known as hold and secure and shelter in place. Hold and secure is used when we must secure the school due to an ongoing situation that is taking place outside of the school and not related to the school. For example, a bank robbery that occurs near the school. In this situation, the school continues to function normally. An administrator would make an announcement over the PA system indicating that the school is going into hold and secure. The emergency response team members would then be posted at each entranceway to ensure that no one leaves or enters the building until the hold and secure is over. During a hold and secure, the exterior facing window drapes should be drawn down and the lights turned off since the threat is outside of the school. With the exterior doors being locked, no one would be allowed in or out of the building until the situation is resolved. And in this case, the police would also notify the school. If staff and students are outside the building, they should re-enter the building prior to the exterior doors being locked. However, once the doors are locked, they should go and proceed to the two alternate evacuation sites. And lastly, the shelter in place is very similar to hold and secure, but it is used for an environmental or weather-related situation where it is necessary to keep all staff and students within the school to protect them from an external situation. This could be a chemical spill, blackouts, or extreme weather conditions. It requires that people enter and remain in the building with the doors and windows closed. The emergency response team members would be posted at each entranceway to monitor the situation. Also, depending on the nature of the incident, fans, heating, and air conditioning units may be required to be turned off to prevent air from coming inside the school. Normal operations would continue within the building, and we would wait for direction from the police department to terminate a shelter-in-place situation. At this time, I will be going off air, and we will be sounding the lockdown tone so that you can become familiar with what it sounds like in case of a lockdown situation. Thank you. Hello, staff and students. Today, we'll be reviewing our lockdown procedures.